Have you seen either of these teams before?
Welcome, everybody. We're in the city of Stonecrest, right outside of Atlanta, Georgia, home of the Georgia Kangaroos, as the Georgia Kangaroos take on Tampa War Ready. We've got maybe a minute or so left before action. If you don't know where Stonecrest is, we're about 20, 30 minutes right outside of Atlanta. Tonight should be an interesting game. It's an exhibition of sorts. Auburn Alumni War Ready out of West Virginia, and we've got Georgia Kangaroos, the home team, here in Browns Mill Recreation Center. Head coach, Brian Caswell. We've got Nichaune Jones, 6'3 guard out of Point University. Devante Foster, 6'9 forward. BK Berezna Stick. Devin Longstreet, guard out of LeBec Community College. Joseph Schner, Grandview, Florida. Gebereal, also known as G. Baitey, Central District Lions, Australia. Damion Rosser, New Orleans University. Frank Champion, North Georgia College. Amir Smith, out of North Macedonia. And Hakeem Jackson. Mongolian National Basketball Association. Now let's take a look at the Auburn side. We've got Well, folks, actually on the Auburn side, War Ready side, they don't have numbers tonight. We're just going to have to go with names and pictures. So hopefully these guys didn't alter their looks too drastically so we can recognize them from what we've known already. As we've got warm-ups here, we've got the teams taking the field, taking the court. For Auburn, we are looking at head coach Frankie Sullivan, assistant coach Jeremy Calzone. We've also got Desean Murray, Danjel Purifoy, Malik Dunbar, Laron Smith, Josh Dillard, Cinmeon Bowers, TJ Dunn, Kareem Canty, TJ Lang, and Javon McCormick. Again, folks, tonight we don't have any numbers for Auburn, so hopefully we'll be able to just recognize who we recognize and keep a good tab on the score. I will be sitting next to the statistician, so hopefully I can give you guys some good numbers, some accurate numbers. Again, welcome to the city of Stonecrest, Georgia, right outside of Atlanta, home of the Georgia Kangaroos, the Georgia Kangaroos basketball. No, that's the same thing. You should be okay. Yeah.
Brought us in here. Next up, they got another TJ.
Folks, we're going to take a listen to the player announcements for Auburn. War ready.
Come on out to the floor, man. Next up, Mr. MD himself, Mr. Malik Dunbar. All right. Next up, we got Javon McCormick. Next up, you got Mr. Smith. This is Mr. Laron Smith. Mr. Smith. Agent Smith. Yeah, I see you over there. You the one bouncing the ball off the damn wall. You can ignore me all you want, Mr. Smith. It's all right. It's all right. Don't worry about it. My kangaroos don't get on your hands, so I ain't even worried about it. That's what we do. All right. Next up, we got Josh Dollar. Next, we got Cinmeon Bowers. Next up, we got Mr. Kareem Canty. And last but not least, is it Danjel Purifoy? All right. And of course, we got the head coach, Mr. Frankie Sullivan, and the assistant coach, Mr. Jeremy Calzon. All right, so those are our visitors. Jay Smith, miles ahead, man. His whole team. All right, so we finna turn it up, man. Kangaroos, y'all ready? Whole squad ready?
So that was your visiting team. War ready. Now we're doing the Georgia Kangaroos lineup here.
Come on, let's get it. Let's go, man. I don't care what y'all say, man. This is what we do. This is home team. First up, at guard, we got Mr. Nichaune Jones. Follow him up at four, we got Devante Foster. Let's go, Rules. Next up, we got Mr. Devin Longstreet. Follow him up. Mr. Joseph himself, Schner. Go ahead and get on it, Joe. Make it rain on your hands, Joe. Next up, we got Gebereal Baitey. Up at power forward, we got Mr. Damion Rosser. Of course, the big man down low, sitting himself, Mr. Frank. Champion, because that's what we got over here at the room. Champions, man, that's what we do. Next up, Mr. Amir Smith. And of course, bringing up the rear, man. Our main star in the center, Mr. Hakeem Jackson. Let's go, Rules, man. Keep the rules, let's get it. We hit the crib, man.
And there you have it, folks. Those are the lineups for tonight's game. We got the Georgia Kangaroos, the home team. War ready as the away team. We also have tonight's officials, Archie Whaley, Lance Walker, and Tanita Dumas. Again, Stonecrest, Georgia, right outside of Atlanta. We are set for some exhibition basketball tonight. A little banter here as we set for a tip-off. Acknowledging the officials, acknowledging the other players. Some sportsmanship going on here. You always want to start off like that. Georgia Kangaroo has their starting five. We got Hakeem Jackson. He's going to jump center. Then we have Damion Rosser, number two. We have Amir Smith. We have J- Gebereal Baitey, but he says just call him G. So we'll just go with G Baitey tonight. We have number 23, Joseph Schner. And that's Kangaroo's starting five. We're going to see if we can pick out War Ready starting five. They have no numbers. But I can tell you Laron Smith will be jumping. And War Ready controls the tip as they go from right to left. Now they're setting at the top as McCormick pulls out. Again, the Smith down low, puts up a shot, and it's off. First rebound of the game. No foul call. And we have possession to War Ready, to Kangaroos. Baitey brings it up, and he hands it over to Damion Rosser. Rosser pulls up from right beyond the arc. McCormick with the rebound, brings it up himself, clears it out as there's a fake and a first three-point shot for War Ready. Purifoy. Actually, I take that back, folks. That's not Purifoy. That was actually Canty. McCormick brings it back up, so now we have a 2-3 score. War Ready on top. Again down. McCormick for three. Now the score is 6-2. McCormick with the long bomb. Baitey crosses half court. Gets it in to Schner. Hakeem Jackson is calling for it in the post. But Rosser pulls up for three. McCormick again. Step back. This time back out. And again, Canty with another shot. This one comes off the. War Ready with a nice pass down low. Kangaroos with a nice pass down low, to Damion Rosser. Now we have a score 6-4. Home team trails by two. Sure with a nice defense down low. But again, Smith loses the ball, loses the handle. Kangaroos bring it. Schner pulls up for three. Not quite there, but the rebound. No foul. Late foul call. Late foul called on War Ready. That will send Amir Smith to the line for two. Amir Smith airballs the first one. We got one more out of North Macedonia. This one off the rim, but this time at least made it to the goal. McCormick. One man fast break, but he brings it back out. McCormick again at the top of the key. They reset it this time. And this one is waved off. They have an illegal screen, so this one is waved off. Kangaroos ball. Now, this is an exhibition tonight, folks, but it's still going to be competitive. Both teams are looking to win. As McCormick actually knocks the ball away from Baitey, but it's still Kangaroo's ball. And taking that from the side, Hakeem Jackson pulls up for three. That one rims out. And this one again, two War Ready. Dunning down to Smith. Smith again banging down low. Another three for War Ready. This one is good. 9-4. Kangaroos having a hard time getting to the rim. Another three. This one off the rim, but they will continue to shoot apparently. Have a loose ball foul on the Kangaroos. So they're waiting on the clock to reset. And Schner brings it in. Schner crossing back and forth, and he finally gets it up against Dunn. Thought it was a reach in. No, they call an illegal screen on Georgia Kangaroos. This ball going to the visiting team as the Kangaroos trail 9-4. Here in Stonecrest, Georgia, home of the Georgia Kangaroos. Again, 20 miles right outside of Atlanta. Nice dish inside. Smith kicks it right back out. Top of the key. And this one is a foul called on Baitey. He'll take it to the side. As Dunbar inbounds the ball to Dunan. Dunbar to Dunan. Say that twice. Dunan dribbles up. Has Schner on him. Decides to go to the basket. And a nice scoop left hand layup. Doesn't fall. Kangaroos out on the fast break. And a slam. And a slam. That's Damion Rosser with the throwdown. McCormick out to Dunan. Dunan for three. And again, War Reddy's just raining down the threes at this point. Baitey trickle dribbles, kicks it back out. Rosser, strong to the basket. And he's fouled on the way to the basket. So again, we have Damion Rosser out of New Orleans University to the line. As he makes the first one, we have subs coming in. We have Devante Foster coming in. We have Nichaune Jones coming in. And we also have Frank Champion coming in. We have Schner, Baitey, and Amir Smith coming out for the Kangaroos. Again, with War Ready, we will try to make out who we have with the numbers, without numbers, I should say. We do know they at least all have the same shirts on, same color shirts. Now this is Purifoy with almost a turnover. And we have a foul on the Kangaroos. On the shot, so we're going to the line again. This time for War Ready. Actually, I think this is War Ready's first trip to the free throw line this game. That is TJ Lang with his first shot. Knocks down two. Got one more. He was foul shooting a three. And he connects on all three. So War Ready 15, Kangaroos 8. Rosser handles at the top of the key. Makes a drive, kicks it out. Three-pointer, no good. War Ready with the rebound. So we have a foul call as War Ready goes to the basket. That's another shooting foul. This one will send Cinmeon Bowers to the line. Cinmeon Bowers misses his first one. Makes it up at the second one. Interesting choice of shorts for Cinmeon Bowers. As we have Nichaune Jones bringing it up. Frank Champion over to Devante Foster. First three of the night for the Georgia Kangaroos. Score 16-11. Purifoy with the miss, but Smith with the rebound. So they got this one back out top. Another three-pointer for We'll read this one off. Prosser with the rebound, brings it up, kicks it on out. No call on the hold there. And an air ball for Nichaune Jones. Pretty sure he wanted that foul call, that the hold around the race. Purifoy takes a three. And Purifoy makes a three. Looking at a 19-11 score. Georgia Kangaroos trying to hang around. Prosser with a nice move to the basket. Probes, comes right back out. Now Foster probing at the top. Foster can't get past Purifoy. Purifoy ends up with the steal. And the rebound. And the shot on the end. We have and one. Purifoy going to the line for one. Purifoy does not cash in on the 3 points, on the 3-point opportunity. Kangaroos take it inside this time and lose the ball. Correction, there's a foul call. So Kangaroos maintain possession. A little discussion here on where the ball is supposed to be taken out at. Rosser inbounds to Foster. And Foster draws a foul. So that's five fouls on War Ready. That's going to send Kangaroos to the line already in the bonus. We'll see if that. We'll see if the Kangaroos can take advantage of that. That would definitely keep them more than just in the game. It's a 21-11 spread right now. You got to make the free throws. You got to make the free throws. Devante Foster with the miss on the first. Lines up for the second one. Thing is, Kangaroos are in the bonus. Every foul gets them the chance to score with the clock stop. Need to take advantage of that if the Kangaroos plan on doing anything here tonight. Purifoy with the ball, kicks it back out. Lane back out to Purifoy. Purifoy with the hesitation and the teardrop. Not quite. Amazing save by Purifoy. Amazing save behind the back. And War Ready loses this one out of bounds. It might be the break Kangaroos could use right here. Prosser back to Nichaune Jones. Takes it right down the alley. Oh, an attempted jump. Nice move by Nichaune Jones. Couldn't finish, though. Again, War Ready. And sign they drew a foul. And that sends Dollar to the line for two. Okay, so Dollar makes the first one. Schner back in for the Kangaroos. As Prosser goes out and gets a breather. Purifoy out for the War Ready. Lines up this one. The free throw is good. War Ready 23, Kangaroos 12. Pull up by Nichaune Jones, well off. Rebound by the Kangaroos. Devante Foster for three, well off. War Ready overthrows the pass, but they maintain the rebound. Nice jump step. War Ready's up 25-12. Kangaroos are not taking advantage of being in the bonus right now. They're steadily shooting threes. But they finally hit one. Finally hit one. That's Devante Foster. It's an out-of-bounds call as War Ready trying to split two defenders. I don't think they'll give him that one. War Ready taking it out on the side. Laying back up to Canty. Pulls up from way downtown, and it was way off. Meanwhile, Schner sneaks down and gets an easy bucket. Kangaroos working their way back in here, 25-17. Dollard brings it up. One-on-one brings it down. As we have an and one, that sends Lang to the line. See if Lang can finish this off, finish this three-point play off. So the foul was on Frank Champion. As he gets the rebound, brings it up himself for the Kangaroos. All the way to the basket. Apparently, no defense. No one stopped him except for himself. Nice defensive play to get the ball back, but it's right back in War Ready's hand. So they slow it down. They run. There's 34 seconds left on the clock. They decide to get into a set. Defense by Nichaune Jones. This time he decides to lay it up instead of trying to attempt a dunk. War Ready takes timeout as the score is 27-19. So maybe Kangaroos can wake up. Nice defensive play there by Nichaune Jones to get down there. Seem to be having some issues with the clock here as well. We'll get that worked out. So again, Mike Gaines here with you, Georgia Kangaroos basketball here in the city of Stonecrest, Georgia. As we have the Georgia Kangaroos taking on War Ready, Tampa War Ready. Now this is a friendly exhibition game, but War Ready doesn't seem to be too friendly right now. They're up by 9, could be more. Kangaroos haven't taken advantage of being in the bonus. 22 seconds left, so we'll see what they do from here. We have a discussion with the referee at the table here. So War Ready brings it in with 22.4 seconds left. Canty brings it up. Canty also with an interesting choice of shorts. As he wards off the defenders. Cross court all the way to Lang. Lang misses another three. Nice defensive hands by War Ready, but the ball goes back to Kangaroos with 1.5 seconds left. Just enough time to do something. Pull up and an air ball by Devante Foster. That's pretty much what the story has been by for the Georgia Kangaroos. They can't quite get it to go. Now they were in the bonus coming into the end of the first period. They didn't seem to take advantage of it though. They were putting up way too many threes. We'll see how this goes. We've got 12 more minutes of basketball, so we'll see how this goes. At least 12 more minutes.
In the building, man. Once again, we go by the name of the MC, your host. For the season, man,
So maybe they can get something going in his next 12 minutes, and then the second half, we'll have another 24 minutes to see what they can make work. All right, folks, we are right outside, like I said, right outside Atlanta, Georgia, city called Stonecrest, home of the Georgia Kangaroos. So now we're coming back with the lineup of G. Baitey, Joseph Schner, Damion Rosser, and this time we got Devante Foster staying out there. So maybe we can get some chemistry going to see how this goes. Maybe we'll see something from the Kangaroos. Already, we see that they've got more of a decisive flow about what they want to do. They've been able to go directly to the basket at will, whether it's a foul or a basket. Some shots haven't been falling, but they've been able to get what they wanted. As we start the second period, Baitey in the process. Cross kicks out to Schner. Schner gets in, but he kicks the ball back out. Jackson is calling for the post. As Jackson was calling for the post, Devante Foster actually throws the ball away outside. You got your big man calling for the post. You might want to feed him. You guys are trying to inch back into this game. You got to make the easy plays. Now there's a foul called on Rosser, as it seemed as if the player just lost the ball off his own foot. Dollard. This time they're going down low with a cross pass to McCormick. Smith again banging inside. Smith with a nice off the glass move, but no shot. This time Dollar gets the rebound and gets the foul. This one is going to be on Devante Foster. So this will send Dollar to the line for two more. All net for Dollar. Line it up, see if we can get another one. And good for Dollar. Now the Kangaroos are making their way back into this game. It's 29-24. It was as much as 10 earlier. As Schner makes a move. Baitey back to Schner. Down and low to Hakeem Jackson, who was actually fouled. He was held on the play. Nice look. That was a nice look inside. He was held on the play. Schner to inbound. Into Jackson again. Jackson cross court. This time Foster. Nice move, but can't finish. That's been the problem with the Kangaroos. They've had some nice moves. They just can't seem to finish. Dollard inside again. Dunans with the ball to the outside. Dunan actually loses the ball. Yeah, Dollard wanted the foul. He was trying to get the foul earlier. Late whistle. He's trying to stop the break, and they finally do call it. Smart move by Dollard. Can keep that momentum at bay. Foster shooting another three. This time he hits. Foster's not shooting bad from outside. As McCormick takes it. Looking for Smith again. Smith with Baitey on him. Smith with a nice move again, but cannot finish. Smith has had a hard time finishing tonight. He's had some nice moves, but he can't seem to finish. Again, another foul down low. This one resulting in an out of bounds. out of bounds pass in from Dunan. Another three. This one good. War ready. Another three. Foster got away with a travel there. Foster, well, not got away with a travel. He was it's a little out of control there. They decided to call that one on him. McCormick getting to the basket. Nice pull up and can't make that one either, but he gets his own rebound. Loose ball foul called on Dollard. Called on Smith. Rosser a little out of control, just dribbling through traffic as he gives it up to Schner. Back to Rosser for a long three. This one good. 32-25. Kangaroos bringing it back. Dunham with a nice pass to Smith out to Dollard. Dollard for three. Oh, not sure what happened there, but Dollard pulled that back. Another three. War ready off. A little out of control play here from Rosser. Well, actually, for both teams, this ball just doesn't seem to stick in anybody's hand right now. Dollard slows it down. Dollard with a step back, and that one's off. Smith battling down low. Dunnins with the rebound to put it back in. Every time the Sharks, the Kangaroos, hard foul. And a hard foul and a hard fall for Baitey. As Purifoy set the check in. Seems like every time the Kangaroos make a sizable run, War Ready just seems to push back, extend the lead again, get things back under control. Looks like War Ready's gonna make a wholesale substitution right there. They're bringing in a whole nother five or four, save McCormick. So let's see if we can get this straight. Again, with no jerseys, let's see if we can get this straight. We've got McCormick in for War Ready. We got McCormick, Canty, Lang, Purifoy, and Cinmeon Bowers. So we got McCormick to the basket with a nice left scoop. Brings the lead up to 12 for War Ready. King Jackson bringing it up top and throws it away right to Purifoy. Purifoy brings it up. McCormick again. Pulls it back out. Canty for a long three. That one's off. So we got Devante Foster bringing it up. He's going one-on-one and just pulls it. That one's off. Schner with the rebound. Back to Foster. Foster, nice step around and a scoop. McCormick back in control. McCormick right to the basket. Foster with a nice foul to stop the play. So we got Nichaune Jones coming in, Frank Champion coming in, and Amir Smith. That sends Hakeem Jackson, Joseph Schner to the bench. And Foster. So War Ready passing it around the horn somewhat. And they go back down low. And again, Bowers with a tip in on his own shot, on his own miss. So Jones brings it up. The trap comes to him immediately. Gets rid of it, Baitey. Baitey for three. In and out. Amir Smith wanted an and one on that rebound. Lang pulls it back out to Purifoy. Canty just walks into a wide open three. They let him free. 41-23. 41-31, excuse me. As McCormick with another scoop left-hand layup. Folks, I don't know. Seems like every time the Kangaroos try to make a comeback, War Ready has a strong, decisive answer. So we got Rosser, champion with another three. That one's off the rim. Bowers with the jam. Kangaroos have got to get this in control. This is starting to get out of hand. So now, oh, we've got an offensive foul. We got Rosser jawing with the referee. Rosser's over here more concerned about the official. It's not going to help them get any closer. It's 45-24. You might need to focus on the court. Bowers with a nice cut to Lane. Nice pass to a cutting Lane. Lane couldn't handle it, but that was a very nice look. ...45-31, folks. Kangaroos not completely out of it, but they're not playing like they're trying to get back in it right now. Rosser took way too many steps. They let him get away with that. Pull up three, and he misses. Laying on the rebound and the fast break. Out to Purifoy. Purifoy with the fake. Pulls up again. Three for Purifoy. 48-31. Sean Jones with the terrible-looking three. Well, folks, War Ready's name is correct. Apropos, they are War Ready. Apparently, the Kangaroos didn't seem to be ready for this game. Still got a lot of basketball left, but they're not showing us anything that's saying they want to get back in this. McCormick gets tugged and pushed and held. No call. And Canty loses the ball out of bounds. We're looking at a little over 2 minutes left here at Stonecrest, Georgia. Kangaroos trying to claw back into this game against War Ready. Well, the officials discussing the call here. It's out on somebody. They just trying to figure out who. And Ross is still jawing with the referee. Ross might be out of this game, folks. He's not even paying attention anymore. He's worried about the officials. Got McCorn out to Purifoy. Out to Canty. So now they got off the ball foul here against War Ready. So now you got Nichaune Jones bringing the ball up for Kangaroos. Gets in the lane and gets a foul. It might be the best way to get back in it. Just keep trying. Again, folks, this is an exhibition, but they are trying out here. War Ready is trying to establish dominance out here. And Kangaroos are trying to frankly show that they belong on the same court. As Nichaune Jones misses first free throw, lines up the second one, rattles this one in. Purifoy in the inbound to McCormick. Minute 35 left. McCormick with a nice cross, kicks right back out to Purifoy. Not quite. G. Baitey all the way. And nice drop off. Was unintentional drop off, but it was a nice dish. As War Ready calls timeout. Oh, excuse me. Delay of game. McCormick again probing. getting a little handsy out here. Every trip down seems to be a whistle. These guys are hacking and scratching and clawing, but I guess that's what happens when you're fighting. Smith in to Purifoy again. Wide open three, Purifoy. This one doesn't go. So now we got Champion on the rebound and Nichaune Jones. Baitey from downtown and good. 37-48, folks. 43 seconds left. Canty dribbles up top to McCormick. McCormick with a nice cross step back. And not enough on there. Champion out to Amir Smith. And too many steps. Too many steps. Amir Smith wanted to make a move before he was able to get the ball. He was thinking about it. It was a little gimpy. Smith a little gimpy. Jackson comes in for him. We hope he's all right. He's walking off on his own power, so that's a great sign. We have Canty bringing it up for War ready. 24 seconds left in this second quarter. Canty actually posting, taking Nichaune one-on-one. Nichaune Jones one-on-one. Step back three. Again off. Nichaune Jones with 8 seconds left on the clock. Ah, not quite. Cross-court pass. And Canty with the rebound and his foul. If you can hear the statistician, that's only 4 fouls on White. That would be the Kangaroos, White. 1 second left. Purifoy gets fouled with 0.5 seconds left. So now we're going to have Purifoy at the line for 2 shots with half a second left on the clock. I'm pretty sure that's not what Champion wanted to do. You didn't want to foul the man on the last second of the half. Purifoy lines up for the first one, rattles it in. One more, and again, half a second left in this first half. A long rebound will end the clock, but Purifoy hits both shots. Inbounds, Baitey for a long distance, and not quite enough. Well, folks, the city of Stonecrest, Georgia, home of the Georgia Kangaroos here at Brown Mills Center. We have the away team, War Ready, 50 points. The home team, Georgia Kangaroos, 37 points. So, folks, we will see you at the second half.
You the man. I'm still in
Back to Stonecrest, Georgia, Kangaroos basketball. We have a 40-37, 13-point difference here. Kangaroos down. See if they can bring a little more energy, a little more savvy and get themselves back into this game. War Ready has been dominating most of the game tonight. So as we inbound, we have Schner inbounding the ball for Georgia Kangaroos. We have Schner, Baitey, Hakeem Jackson, Rosser, and actually we have a new face in here. Amir Smith. We haven't seen him in a minute. King Jackson down low and is fouled immediately by Smith. We have Smith, Dollard, Dunans, Dunbar, and McCormick in for War Ready. And King Smith down on the block again. This time takes it himself, and nice move up and under on Smith. Smith controlling for the elbow. McCormick bring the ball out for War Ready. So we have 50-39. So it's an 11-point game. It's not completely out of hand. It just looks different with two different digit sets. Schner brings the ball up. Off of War Ready turnover, and there's a block call. War Ready wants to travel. Kangaroos will accept the block. Oh, So we got Baitey inbounding to Rosser. Rosser to the basket and draws a foul. So this one was Dollard. We're already coming out a little lackadaisical on the defensive end. So again, Damion Rosser to the line. Damion Rosser out of New Orleans University. 6'4 forward. And rattles this one out. That's not gonna happen the second time around, I don't think. Let's see what Rosser does this time. That one was pure. McCormick up. Four ready. So it's a 10-point game. McCormick navigates and gets a high one off the glass. High floater off the glass. Nice move. McCormick seems to just know when to take control of the game again as Rosser tries to bully his way in. Loses control. This time Jackson saves it. Baitey for three. This one's off as Dunan gets the rebound. Again, McCormick with the ball. And McCormick just surgically goes into the paint, draws in the defense. If they have something, he brings it up. You know. So they've got a foul and count the basket, goaltending. So we've got McCormick going to the basket, shooting one. As I was saying, McCormick seems to just make the smart plays. He probes, see if there's anything in there. And if there's nothing in there, he doesn't force anything. So now we have a lane violation on McCormick, though. He's off before it hits the rim. He complaining like he's trying to say he's that fast. McCormick is saying he's that fast. So Rosser is handling the ball to Schner. Schner out to Baitey. Baitey having a hard time controlling the ball. Smith back out to Baitey. Baitey for three. And that one's off. Schner with the rebound. And you got Prosser along three. Not in. Oh, they called this one off. Amir Smith with the goaltending. He got up for that one, though. Amir Smith got up. So now we have an issue with the clock here. Hold on 1 second, folks, as we can't get the clock to stop. Apologize for the noise in the background if you can hear that beep. Imagine what we're hearing. We're right up on it. So have a 14-point game. Kangaroos behind War Ready, 54-40. Got things reset again. So we have Dunan with the ball up top against Schner. Nice crossover. And he crosses again. And an up fake. He's going for the lob. Smith brought it back down. Couple elbows. Couple spins. And he finally gets a foul. Schner with a nice defensive effort. But at the end, got him just a little bit. At least that's what the officials say. Again, the officials for tonight's game, Archie Whaley, Lance Walker, and Tanita Dumas. So with that one, Smith misses the free throw. It's still a 14-point game. Kangaroos still have time. This is only the third quarter. And Smith misses both free throws. Again, the door is still open. The door is still open. Schner with an up fake. Cross-court pass to Bailey. To Baitey. Baitey with a nice inside pass to Hakeem Jackson. They actually have not been going to Hakeem Jackson a lot lately. As Canty probes, back to Bowens. Dunbar all the way to the basket. Nice scoop, but he could not get it in. So Prosser with a nice look away pass to Schner. Schner for three. Not quite. Dunbar brings it back. Dunbar with a nice move into the paint. As Prosser probes and dribbles again. Baitey for three again. Nice no look from Schner to Baitey to Jackson, and Jackson could not finish the playoff. Purifoy with a nice layup, even after being contested. So we got a timeout on the Kangaroos. 58-14. Okay, so a little confusion on the play. It wasn't a timeout, it was just a substitution. Problem with having two ears, you hear two separate things in both sides of them. That's Prosser out to Baitey. Baitey pulls up again for three. This one finally goes down for Baitey. So now it's a 13-point game. As Canty cross half court. And Baitey's three has been changed to a two. As Bowen's down on the post. Dunbar. And Lang hits three. So the Kangaroos hit a two, and Lang comes down and makes War Ready up and erases that with a three. Now Dunbar with the ball to Purifoy. Purifoy again with a nice scoop layup. Sure. On an attempted alley-oop. Foster a little bit too strong for him. Dunbar with a nice layup that just didn't fall. Schner again for nice down low pass. And Amir Smith misses the shot and then wants to call the timeout. Amir Smith got no lift on that layup, so something must. He's walking off as if something's wrong with his ankle, so we'll see. He might still be bothered by that earlier injury on that. So we got War Ready back in. Lang all the way back to Canty. Canty back against Nichaune Jones. And Sean's locked in on defense. Dunbar for three, and it's good. So that brings the lead to 22. And Foster loses the ball off his foot. Thankfully, Nichaune Jones gets a loose ball, pulls up for deep, and nails it. Canty comes right back with a three of his own and nails it. Just neutralized that three. Nichaune Jones back down. Not sure if they'll be able to trade baskets at this point. And Champion loses the ball, but gets it down to Foster again. And this one is blocked by War Ready. Purifoy bullied his way in, and he's rewarded. That's what they're discussing with the officials right now, with some of the players from Kangaroos, trying to figure out how he's rewarded with that when he's the one to initiate it. But when it's bang-bang plays like that, officials, it's usually a judgment call, and it could probably go either way. You got to take into account angle and what things they see. They're closer to the court anyway, so you're going to, just like right there, they've got another. Off the ball foul. Defensive play by Champion to knock that one out. Knock that entry pass out. Laying up to Canty. Canty has a very high dribble. That one got tipped away by Nichaune Jones. Canty has a very high dribble. I don't know if he wants to keep playing with Nichaune Jones like that. So we're having a shot clock situation here. They need to they want the set. Shot clock reset to 7. So they're saying shot clock doesn't reset them changing unless it changes possession. And an alley-oop to Dunbar. Nichaune Jones for 3. Way off. Bowens with the rebound. We're already coming back on the hunt. Late whistle. It's a late whistle on the Kangaroos, but that was a nice inbounds pass to Dunbar for the alley-oop. So we got Bowens to the line. And if you're just joining us, yes, the score is correct. It is 72-47. Auburn alum, Tampa War ready. Georgia Kangaroos, not able to get their footing and make this a game like you would expect for them to. As Bowen knocks down both free throws. He had 6 men on the court earlier. They had to rectify that. So Nichaune Jones all the way to the basket. Nice scoop. Still some life in the Kangaroos. Still some life. They can't seem to get it consistently, but they've got life. Purifoy from the line. Canty sizing up Nichaune Jones. Step back. All water for Canty. All water. Champion with a nice break. Canty right back with an exaggerated step back. No good. Champion with a nice pass in to Foster with a jam. Points. We're ready looking to hold off this surge from the Kangaroos. Under 2 minutes left in the third period. We still got some more basketball left. Dunbar with a nice pass back in the Purifoy. Rosser sizing up the defense. Picks up his dribble. Nichaune Jones looking to get it in. The champion down on the block. They've got McCormick down on the block, so he needs to take advantage, and he does. Catches a foul. He wanted the shot, but he got the foul. So we got Frank Champion out of North Georgia College. And misses the first free throw. So for the rest of the way, both teams will be in the bonus. Champion couldn't connect on either free throw as McCormick brings the ball up against Nichaune Jones. And McCormick goes right by, throws the lob. Purifoy out for the 3. Not quite. Baitey back to champion. Champion can't capitalize. Back out to Baitey for three. No good. Dunning with a long outlet pass. McCormick holding off Schner. Right to the basket and can't get the scoop. Schner back to Baitey. Baitey tries to go behind the back and it goes off of the leg. Fortunate there. Yeah, so substitutions as Dunbar and Lane come off the court. We have Bowens, Smith, and Dollard. Alongside of Canty and as we inbound this Foster. Foster doing work, but losing his footing, turns around and not quite. Nichaune Jones with a nice scoop, but can't get it to go. 25 seconds left. McCormick brings it up to the half court. Back out to Canty. Canty slows it down. And Nichaune Jones with the quickness. Couldn't quite get it, but he was there for the pass. Dunning with a nice cross out to Canty. So Dollar just tied up. It's the and one. And even less Nichaune Jones, no, he's just not big enough. So we have a 25-point game with 2.9 seconds left in the third quarter. Dollar can't connect on the free throw. And Nichaune Jones from deep, not quite. So again. Tampa War ready, Auburn alone, 78. Georgia Kangaroos, 53. Heading into the fourth quarter, this is the final stand. Let's see what the Kangaroos can do.
Make sure to follow us on social media. That's all social media at the DJ team. And don't forget to follow the Kangaroos on Instagram at Georgia Kangaroos. That's all one word, Georgia Kangaroos on Instagram. Also follow Cinmeon Bowers on Instagram. Last quarter, man. Four quarters, 12 minutes left. Leave it all on the floor. That's what we're going to do, man. Leave it all on the floor. Kangaroos. Let's get it, man. Come on, we're gonna come back. Now's the time to come back now. Gotta come back now. Let's go, man. BJT, we in here.
All right, welcome back, Stonecrest, Georgia. Home of the Georgia Kangaroos. Unfortunately, Auburn, Tampa War ready. Have been a slightly rude house guest. They're up 78-53 in the home of the Georgia Kangaroos. I'm Mike Gaines here with you. Browns Mill Recreation Center as we get this fourth quarter started. Canty into Dunning. Dunning brings it across half court. So to start this quarter, we've got Dunning, Canty, Smith, Dollard, and McCormick. As Dunning pulls a deep three, does not go. Nichaune Jones fouled on the break. Nichaune Jones with Damion Rosser, Joseph Schner, Devante Foster, and we've got G. Baitey. Nichaune Jones with a pull up. Still off. McCormick quickly out the gates. So Smith gets fouled on the way up. Smith with the first one. Knocks it down. Scores now 79-53. Loads up for the second one. And not quite. Foster with the rebound. Schner for three. And that's good. Joseph Schner for three. Grandview, Florida. McCormick right back and gets the ball taken. Kangaroos on the break. And can't quite capitalize. Two attempts and still can't capitalize. McCormick stopped the break by itself. A one-on-three break. This break was stopped as well. Got an offensive on War Ready. Crosser with the drop off. Nichaune Jones in and can't get it to drop, but he's going to the line. So Nichaune Foster misses the first free throw, trying to add to his 6-point total. And he does make it 7. So we got Dollard taking the ball out. So McCormick and Canty in the backcourt for War Ready. Dunan probing and pulls it back out. And Foster with the interception. Schner down. And Nichaune Jones gets fouled on the way up. And a little clock mishap got everybody a little confused with what's going on. But it's Nichaune Foster back to the line. Again, another missed free throw. As Bowens comes in for Smith. Tampa already has got a firm grasp on this game as Nichaune Jackson hits his free throw. 79-58. Not quite over, but it's a tough ask to get the Kangaroos, for the Kangaroos to get back in this thing. War Ready. McCormick for the deep three. See, every time Georgia seems to make some kind of headway, War Ready comes right back as Baitey just drains a three. Nice step back by Baitey. 21-point game. McCormick slows the pace down a little bit. They go into Dollard. Even with an increasingly large lead, War Ready continues to go inside. They continue to take the easier buckets. Nichaune Jones, deep three. Still life in them. 20-point difference, 7 minutes, 55 seconds left. Might not have enough time here, but they can still fight. Bowens has Schner on him, and demanded the ball. Couldn't capitalize, though. Nichaune, and you got a slam from Rosser. From Nichaune Jones. Nice dish. Nice dish off from Nichaune Jones. 18-point lead. Dunning with the miss on the floater. Foster with the rebound. And I think Warready wanted to carry on Deshaun Foster. Devante Foster, excuse me. So we got Bowers. We got Canty slowing it down. Canty changing his pivot feet a couple times, but the official, I guess, let that one go. From deep. And a loose ball foul on Warready. So Kangaroos have a chance to get this thing within at least within 10 or 15. 84-68. And Rosser decides to take a long three. You guys within range to get this thing to 14 points, and you decide to take a long three. Right. Great defensive effort on the other end, though. Baitey down to Rosser. Rosser with a nice dump down to Foster with another jam. There's some life here, 14 points. Again, it's not over. Just a big task ahead, that's all. Not over, though. Canty looking to slow it down. Sizes Foster up with a step back and drains the three. Again, every time Georgia makes a big gash into the lead, Warready just happens to have an answer for him. And with that being said, Nichaune Jones takes a long three. Rebound goes to Warready. And again, McCormick decides to go inside, but this one was picked off. Prosser pulls up again for what looked like a three. Was a nice dish. Nice dish to Baitey. So we got a timeout by Warready. We got a nice comeback brewing here. We've got Georgia Kangaroos 72, Tampa Warready 87.
Control them, bro. It's a 15-point game.
So Tampa Warready, every time Georgia Kangaroos seem to make some headway into that lead, they've got an answer for them, whether it's a deep three or just constantly pounding it in the paint. And every time it seems like Georgia Kangaroos are getting back or getting close to the lead, sometimes they just don't seem to make the correct play. They're shooting the long three when they're down, when all they need is a two-pointer to get it within 14 points. You know, a two-pointer to get it under 15, two-pointer to get it. You know, normally they probably can shoot those threes and probably can shoot the lights out, but if it's not falling, you got to go for what you can get. So we'll see what the strategy is with 4:28 left in the fourth quarter. Again, Mike Gaines here with you, Kangaroos basketball, as we are set to resume play. 4:28 left in the fourth period. Tampa Warready 87, Georgia Kangaroos 72. Stonecrest, Georgia, right outside of Atlanta. Nice evening for some basketball here. Inbounds the ball. Lang has it in the backcourt. So they. Oh, late whistle on Georgia Kangaroos. But again, you see Warready. They slow it down and they go inside. Something's bound to happen. You're either going to get a call or a basket. And if neither of those, at least have a chance at a rebound.
at offensive rebound. So Dunbar hits the first one. Puts the lead back up to 16. Dunbar knocks both down. Lead back up to 17. Nichaune Jones probes his way through the paint and collects a foul. Kangaroos long three from Schner. But they get the offensive rebound. And Jones with a step back three that is not quite on target. But Rosser with the putback. And another timeout for Auburn. Tampa War ready.
Another timeout. They're going to use all those timeouts. With 3.5 minutes left, they're going to use them all. The unfortunate part about it is without the clock running, we can't run the time. So they got to run the clock.
First team to 89 is what? 97.
So I don't know if you're able to hear at home the explanation given by official Archie Whaley. There's a little tweak in the rule called the Elam ending. So under 4 minutes in this fourth quarter, there's a target score that the leading team has to get to, like an 8-point target score. So with that being said, the score is 89-74. So what we're looking at, I think, is 89 plus 8. You got me doing my math again. I wasn't told there was going to be math, but that would be 97 point target score. Excuse me. So we'll see how this plays out. We got McCormick down low to Canty. Canty sizing up Nichaune Jones. Hasn't really been able to get past Nichaune Jones tonight. Dunbar with a pump fake. Pull up and another three. 92-74. Nichaune Jones with a nice move inside. Everything but the basket. Hit every corner of the rim, too. Canty with another three. This one off. Walks away from the rebound, assuming he hit that one. Baitey with a nice drop off to Nichaune Jones again. Nichaune Jones has been very active this second half. Purifoy with a nice move again. This one, too much English on it. Couldn't even touch the rim, just too much. Nichaune Jones into Rosser. And Rosser collects a foul, so he will go to the line for two. Rosser hits the first one. 92-77. 15-point game. I have a bevy of substitutions here. Dunning comes in. Purifoy goes out. Lane goes out. And Canty goes out. Dunning has room but isn't shooting. They're electing to run the time off the clock. And he pulls up finally. And probably should have just let the time run out. That was the air ball. And another reach-in foul. This one on Dunning. With him being in the penalty, that sends Rosser to the line again. And Rosser has been making them pay at the free throw line. He's been connecting more often than not. Lines up the first one, and it's good. And the second attempt is good as well. 92-79. 13-point game. 13-point lead for War Ready. And Javon McCormick, you look for him to make the smart play usually when it comes to this point. Smith could not get handle on that dunk. Baitey in the Rosser. Schner for three. And it's good. 10-point game. As stated earlier, not impossible. Just have to make the right play. As McCormick takes a three. Ball out of bounds to War Ready. Dunbar cross court to Dunning. And looks like we have a shot clock violation on War Ready. No, they called a foul. Okay, they called a foul on the Kangaroos. Official Tanita Dumas has a foul. Right as the shot clock's expired. That's got to be frustrating. If you're Georgia Kangaroos, that has got to be frustrating. You clamp down on defense that long and let up that one moment as Dunning knocks it in. So that puts it back up to 11 points. Again, with the Elam ending, there's no clock. No game clock at this point. If I'm understanding this correctly, we're playing to a target score. While Foster goes to work, but picks up his dribble and nearly throws it away. Rosser inbounds. G. Baitey back to Rosser. Rosser surveying things. Pulls up a deep three. Well, that kind of summarizes what Georgia's been doing all night tonight. Every time they get close, they make some kind of mistake. First to 97. So now we've got the target score is 97, and with this three right here, that just ended it. So there you have it, folks. Auburn alum, Tampa War Ready, 97. Georgia Kangaroos, 82. Here in the city of Stonecrest, Georgia, right outside of Atlanta, Georgia, home of the Georgia Kangaroos. Thank you for joining us for Kangaroos basketball. I'm Mike Gaines. And we'll see you guys next time.
Once again, follow us on all social media at Georgia Kangaroos. That's Georgia Kangaroos, as well as the TBT on all social media. We want to thank everybody for coming out tonight. Shout out to all of our Auburn visitors.